Judy Nelson, Tom Cool.
Also excused.
Emily Lee.
Here.
Andrea Anderson.
Here.
Erin Kavanaugh.
Here.
Okay, let's stand and pledge.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone, for coming, and thank you, Rich, for joining us again. Do we have any comments from visitors tonight? Okay, next is the consent calendar, and I actually have some changes to some of the minutes, so you need to pull the minutes off the consent calendar. And I think then they move down to discussion items, is that right? So we'll add that as item 6.6 under discussion items. Next, announcements.
I have a couple of things.
You have to accept the consent calendar with the amendment.
The other, you're removing all of them?
Yep. So we have to...
You have to accept the calendar as amended usually.
Don't we wait till we amend it?
Well, because the enrollment's still on there, so you usually approve what's still left on there.
I see. Okay, great, thank you.
All right.
Thank you. We have a motion to accept the consent calendar as amended.
To make that motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Motion passes. Thank you, Katie.
Bye.
No, thank you. She's our boss.
All right, ready? I have a couple of things for announcements tonight. As you know, it's a busy time of year, lots going on. Exciting time to celebrate our students. I did want to mention, as I talk about this, these security funds, the grant or reimbursement that CAPE had applied for back in March, the state has anticipated a release of additional funding. So that committee that's been doling out these funds did meet again. Unfortunately, they did not decide at this point to move this Rollinsford's project forward. It is still on the wait list. The wait list is small, I will say. We received no feedback from them, so I don't have any information as to why or why not. All they did say on this list was that it was not listed in by priority. So you could be at the top of the list, you could be at the bottom of the list, but at this point they have not moved these projects forward. This committee meets again in August 2nd. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. It's frustrating because I'm not sure why. We're not talking a lot of money, so it's frustrating, but at least there's more money, so hopefully, because they are accepting another round of applications. So there's been some pushback from districts around the state saying, well, why aren't you taking care of the first round if we're asking for the second round? So they're working through whatever their process is. So hopefully this will eventually get moved forward, but at this point it has not. So I wanted to tell you that. That said, we are going to continue. I mean, the work has been scheduled for different projects, and we also have a meeting next week for the engineering study. So we will be moving forward with that. Tech will be down next week. It's Monday, and meeting with Keaton, Dick, and I will talk about facility and start to put that in place so that you have that information to help you move forward. Let's see, like I mentioned before, celebration time of year. Had a chance to see Bailey get recognized as part of the top 10 as our class valedictorian at Summersworth High School this year. So that was a nice event. The students, and you probably will talk about this, I don't want to steal your thunder.
Oh, you go for it.
Okay. It's just a nice time. The students get to bring family members, but they also get to choose a teacher that influenced them. So I'll let you talk about that if you'd like. But it was just, it's just nice. And they talk about why they chose this person and their influences and things like that. So I just wanted to to mention that, and I want to thank both of the student reps. I mean, this is not always an easy thing to do and to commit to, and I know it's hard with all sorts of, you know, different commitments that you have, but, you know, your voice really is important on the board. The board does value what you have to say and appreciates the time that you are able to devote to coming to the meetings and sharing what happens in your schools with the board. So I just wanted to thank you for that. Last night, I was at the sixth grade recognition, and I have to say, it was probably one of the most, it was just a beautiful, lovely ceremony. What I loved about it was that it celebrated kids. And sometimes, and I heard some things about the ceremony, that it had been a lot bigger in years past. There was dinners and prom gowns and all of these kinds of things, and I applaud you for not going over the top, you know, because sometimes we lose what we're really celebrating when it becomes more about a dress or a decorations or the meal or the whatever. But there really was just a very genuine celebration of kids. And I sat there and smiled the whole night because it was just beautiful. And I you know, commend all of you for that. As we know, a lot of that has to do with cake. And, you know, I won't go on because I probably would get a little misty-eyed myself as I talk about cake. But, you know, my last meeting here with you tonight, and I know this will be Kate's last meeting, that, you know, one of the things that she did last night was talk to each of the kids about what she had learned from them. And, you know, I learned a ton from Kate. Kate and I have been through some interesting times and roads together. But if I had to share what I have taken from you, I would say that my message would be that I've learned to take education very seriously, but not to take myself too seriously. We laugh, we enjoy, we close the doors and we like vent and all of that. But when it comes down to it, this is a serious business. And Kate, that is what I will take away. And there's not a more passionate and devoted and just intellectual educator that I've worked with. And I appreciate everything that I've learned from you and you know, wish you well. Disappointed that now that I'm gonna be done as the interim, that I was hoping we would have more time together. But I'm sure our paths will cross as the years go on. And again, as I mentioned, this is my last meeting as the interim superintendent, so I just want to thank the board for your support. I know it's been an interesting year on a lot of fronts, and I've learned a lot, and again, appreciate, you know, your feedback and support. Hopefully we've been able to kind of navigate through some things, and I continue to be in touch with Bob Dunosky, you know, throughout the 6 months that, you know, in this transition period. I know he's anxious to get started. You know, I have a list of things you saw the other day, of things for him, for Rollinsford, and so I'm sure he will hit the ground running. So that's what I have.
Thank you, Laurie. I hope we will continue to be able to work with you.
I hope so. Absolutely.
So moving on to communications. We talked about this a little bit last time in the roofing meeting, but just good news. We were able to keep our Title I supplies, so we won't have to spend extra funds just to keep those, even though we're not getting Title I funding. For this year, so that
must have hurt us. I felt like they hurt us.
Yes.
That was the rage. I realized
they couldn't believe I kept saying, what? Yes. Crazy. More good news. Judy asked me to share with you that thanks to the hard work and perseverance of Beverly Thomas at the New Hampshire Preservation Alliance, we received a matching grant for the historical study that we did a while ago, which resulted in the building being named to the Registry of Historical Buildings. So the good news with that is that we could be eligible for future grant monies after receiving that. So many thanks to Beverly Thomas for helping us out with that. And next is the discussion items, principal update.
Here.
World's busiest week.
It's been really busy, but it's been such a fantastic last 3 weeks. The kids have had some really tremendous experiences, everything from nature's classroom to the sea dogs to the state house. It's just been spectacular. Just celebrating a lot of changes that are coming, and there's definitely some anxiety, but there's also real excitement around change and investing in a new way and learning in a new way. It's just been really, it's been a really special 3 weeks, and we're all really, really tired. But it's been fantastic. We had the talent show on
Tuesday.
It was genius. The kids were so good and confident, and kids that had never done it before were up there. And Mr. Franks was the MC, and it was painfully funny, like rolling on the ground funny. It's just been, I mean, every event last night was an amazing, really special night with the sixth graders. It was, I mean, I've never seen a group of sixth graders so supportive of one another. So the slideshow was on, and there was genuine hysteria the entire time. And it wasn't like, it was like, they go, oh my god, like every one of them around each other in a really cool way. I haven't felt like that same level of commitment to each other in a really long time. It was really beautiful. It's, everything's been spectacular. No complaints.
Well, as I'm sure you can imagine, there was relatively little to report. Everything is all, either already ended or will very soon. Tomorrow will be the absolute last day of school for all underclassmen, because tomorrow is the last day for underclassmen exams. Seniors completed all their academic requirements about a week and a half ago. And all the graduation activities, including graduation itself, have been carried out over the last week, which includes senior banquet, convocation, graduation, and project graduation. The yearbook dedication this year was given to the cafeteria staff, because at the beginning of the year we've invested heavily in upgrading the food and the availability and quality of the food provided in the cafeteria. So we were very grateful to the people who were able to make that possible. Day of school for next year will be on Tuesday, September 4th, after Labor Day, as always.
Great, thank you, thank you.
So, yes, mine's also pretty short. Things are coming to an end. As Lori said, we had our senior assembly this past Tuesday, as well as our top 10 breakfast. Both were really awesome. Really, really cool things to be part of, and just seeing everyone support each other and celebrate each other, and it was really, really nice. So as far as kind of clubs and student organizations go, rapidly coming to an end, which is crazy. So Student Council is doing an end-of-year dessert bar for staff on their, I believe, their last teacher development day. I've actually been kicked out of meetings, so I'm kind of just like dropping for any details I can get. And then our National Honor Society chapter is... This is actually pretty cool. We were contacted directly by the head of the police department in Summersworth to clean up after the food truck festival on this upcoming Saturday, June 17th? Sunday 17th, yeah. So we'll be doing that at 5 to help them out. And then as far as our classes go, the freshmen, the incoming sophomore class, will be having their first car wash on this Saturday at VIP Auto from 11 to 4. The incoming juniors explored a, I'm so sorry, okay, they switched advisors, which is really bold before their junior year. They're really excited about it, which is awesome to see, and they're also planning fundraisers for the summer and the beginning of the year to plan for prom. And then the incoming seniors explored a senior banquet venue, and they're working on finding a new historian. And then seniors are done. We just had our senior banquet last Friday, and then we have our project graduation tomorrow. And then graduation's tomorrow at 6 o'clock at the Whittemore Center at UNH. That's kind of it.
Well, you guys are about to also get kicked out of this meeting. You're welcome to stay, of course, but
have a thing. Bailey, what did you pick for a teacher at your top 10
Daryl Dunbar, I don't know.
Mr. Dunbar.
Yeah. He's one of the, he's in large part the reason why I want to be a math teacher. So,
yeah.
It's good to have him.
Thank you guys so much.
Congratulations, Noah.
Congratulations.
has one?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Can we just say a march for them?
Yep, we have 11, 11-ish graduating, and that's it.
All done.
There we go.
Interesting. Next up on the agenda is the school spring advertising, and we've talked about this a few times, really getting our job ads in front of the right people and using the most popular job boards to reach candidates who are local and maybe also not local looking to relocate, so do you have some info on that?
We do, and I'm actually going to turn it over to Melinda, so I think most people know, but maybe not. Melinda not only takes the minutes, but she's also the HR person for the district, so she's the one that does the postings and things like that. So we had talked about this, and she reached out to School Spring, and I'll turn it over to her to tell you how much this would cost.
I spoke to Justin Metcalf yesterday at School Spring, and he is more than happy to sell his product to me. I started out asking what it would cost for both districts together as an SAU. And it was going to be $3,000 a year. I then stated that I wasn't sure if Summersworth would be on board, as we haven't discussed it with the SAU board or anything. And he said if Rollinsford was to go alone, it would be $2,000 a year without Summersworth. But if you took the two together, it would be a savings, and it would only be $3,000 for the total two districts together. So he did send me, and I did copy it off, a proposal of both districts together. He is willing, if Rollinsford wanted to say yes to it now, with the thought that Summersworth would come on in the fall, he was willing to start with just Rollinsford, and they would prorate the price for now. But he didn't give me the prorated price.
What about pricing for one-off postings rather than an annual fee? Is there a package you can get with, say, I think on their website there were three posts?
Are you sure that's not Indeed? Oh, I see what you're saying. There were three different choices. He didn't discuss that.
Because we looked at it the other day, we saw that there was a, like if you wanted one posting, and it was basically a blast out there, and then there's three, and then it's, a blast out there.
So for one job,
this would be unlimited.
Right. So I'm on their website right now. For one job posting, 60-day featured exposure, basic search for candidates, and national candidate pool, it's $250. For a three-job pack, which is the same thing for three jobs, it's $650, and then the other pitch.
And I wonder if that three-job pack, if you can use it, is it just for 1 year? I wonder when it expires. Or
job credits can be used at any time and never expire.
He is going to call me tomorrow, so I can ask about that. He didn't even broach that. Like I said, he was all into selling the package.
And I'm also wondering how it works with the SAU, if we had needed to post a position.
If you do an SAU-wide, it would also live in the SAU budget.
Yeah.
So it would be an SAU expense, not a Rollinsford expense out of your budget. So it would be an SAU expense.
And then
so we could use it to post at the SAU office, Summersworth could use it to post it, and you guys could use
right.
it.
Right, so that would make more sense.
I believe, yes, that's where it should lie, if that's what you want to do.
The issue is with timing.
Right.
We have to wait for an SAU board meeting to approve this spend, and we're kind of hamstrung with posting this summer.
Which is what I said to him. I wasn't sure how this would play out because the SAU board
wouldn't be meeting till September.
I'm sure if we discussed it with him, I'm sure maybe he could, you know, maybe even cut us a deal on the one posting to get you started now, and then we could talk about the SAU expense in September. I'm sure we could talk to him about that. You know, if they're willing to, wanting to sell you a product, I'm sure they're gonna work with you to start it. So we could do the three package one.
Right.
Maybe probably at a cheaper rate than they're probably advertising. I'm willing to bet if we talk to him about that.
Maybe they would allow, saying that, you know, we need to approve it, would they allow this going towards?
The total cost.
I mean, for Rollinsford alone, it's where you need to put more than three per year on this website, so that's $650 a year, so why would we ever pay?
$2,000.
For us, that would make no sense at all.
Right.
I don't know SAU-wide how many jobs we post per year, so maybe SAU-wide it would make sense, but I think.
We post a lot. This year you posted quite a few jobs.
Yeah, there was a lot.
I mean, we spent a lot this year, so I mean, there are years where you're gonna have the increase, so.
That also includes your SAU positions.
Exactly. To me, it just makes more sense to be in the same expense.
What does it cost to post in the newspaper? Isn't that a few dollars?
We will be saving by not doing that.
Yeah.
In the newspaper? It's $200 to $300 depending on the size of the ad.
And we do also right now pay a SAU expense to Ed Jobs, so we could consider not doing that if we did school spring.
It's $1,100 a year for Ed Jobs.
Is that, and that's SAU?
That's an SAU expense, yep. It services both districts.
Is that New Hampshire only, Ed Jobs?
Yep.
The newspaper puts it online too. They do have it online for 1 week when you.
Right.
I think that if you guys could talk to him.
Yeah, he's calling me tomorrow.
Stay, you know. If we were to put two jobs on, would you give us a break knowing that?
That we will.
Likely, you know, try and get it approved by the SAU board at our next meeting. We can't guarantee anything, obviously, but.
Or at least roll it over when you did go SAU-wide. So if they won't give you a break, they try to stick you, just roll it over when you.
But because the decision will be made most likely in the next couple of months.
Yeah, your next SAU board meeting is not until September. And I think that was why, because we originally talked about this as being an SAU expense because of the reasons Katie said. I mean, it really makes sense for it to live there, but it was concerned that you're not getting the applicant pool. So, you know, how can we try to do something? But yeah, I mean, we could talk to them and say, look, you know, we're interested, so help us out, you know, and I can't believe we would be able to. I mean, you're gonna pay for the, you know, for the smaller subscription, but.
I mean, we could also talk to Summersworth and get their sense on our workshop on the 26th. I mean, it would be an informal discussion with them. You know what I mean? Try to see if they're on board, you know what I mean? If it's something that they're willing to look at, you know, kind of get an idea, so we could give him a better idea.
I know you're just interested.
I want to post as soon as humanly possible.
Yeah, I think we should.
No, I'm saying.
No, I just mean for like communications tomorrow and Monday and Tuesday, then we're looking at, by the time we register to the end of next week, I just want to be all of us cognizant of that the pool gets smaller and smaller as we get into summer because people are taking jobs. And I think we have to just be really thoughtful about that. And we posted over a month ago for some of the positions and got 3 or 4 applicants. That's a big deal.
I think it would make sense after discussion if we authorize the expense and then post the positions, and if we can get them to apply it to the larger amount later, then that would be great. But maybe independent of the decision tonight.
Yeah, I make a motion to appropriate $650 for the three job pack to post jobs to Josh Ring, school spring.
One second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Thank you. And next up is choosing a date for our board retreat. Traditionally, we've done this in April, but last year as well as this year, we did it more in the summertime so that we could have the incoming superintendent take part. So Judy talked about picking a date in June or July. We can do an evening. It's usually 3 to 4 hours. Or we we could do a Sunday like we did last year. So we have to sort of coordinate our schedules as well as Bob's schedule for the summer. So, and also Tom and Judy aren't here to give us their availability, so I'm wondering if maybe we can, yeah, pick a couple dates that work. See if everyone's available.
So we don't have any input from anyone else.
Right. Or maybe if we have, if we email when we're not available, I'll try to pick a couple dates and see if they fly. I'm not sure what the best approach is. It's always a very long, crazy discussion. But just to get that going, it might make sense to do it in July because we don't have a board meeting. Although July is a very busy vacation month, so.
I would prefer July, actually.
Really?
Okay.
I only have 1 week in July that I'm not available. And that's the week that I'm pretty good.
2 weeks that I'm definitely not available. The 9th and the 23rd.
So maybe the week of the 16th.
Let me throw that out there.
Yeah, so
do that one.
The week of the 16th or the last, or the
first few days.
Right, July into August, the 30th, 31st.
Okay. I'll send that around and we'll see with everybody if we can pick a date on one of those 2 weeks.
Okay. And I can let Bob know that you're looking at those weeks.
I mean, my understanding is going to be here all summer, but the week started populating this calendar on the meetings and things, so.
Okay. I will include you on that long and crazy email. Next up is an action item, authorizing the superintendent to hire over the summer, which we've traditionally done.
Here, 6.6.
Oh, I skipped my own discussion. Thank you. Yes, yeah, so there were a couple places in the minutes where I think I said something that it was indicated that it was Emily. So the first one, and I'll give you this also, so I just circled them. On the May 31st minutes, at the very bottom of the approval of annex bids, it says, Leach asks how long they anticipate the job to take.
Mm-hmm.
I actually asked that question. Not earth shattering, I know. I just remember saying it. And then the other one is, this is the May 10th minutes. Under financial update, number 8, but on the second page of it, at the very top, Leach stated that she feels the board should move forward with the security projects either way, safety and security wise. And that was actually me.
And then there was this one.
Oh, yep. That on the same minutes, section 13, comments by visitors. She stated that she is hoping that the board and staff ensure that there is enough school time built into the schedule next year to alleviate the need to make up snow days at the end of the year. And that was Celia Leopold, who was part of that conversation, and not Andrea. So I'll give you those afterwards so that you know exactly where they are.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you for reminding me to do that. Summer hiring, now. Do you want to say anything about that?
Well, I think it's just something that's typically done, because you don't need. I think it's just a board action, correct, that you just authorize the superintendent to do any hiring that you need over the summer.
Okay.
You will have a couple of positions, as you know, so be advertising on school spring. And,
yes.
Likely those will probably be for Bob as he comes in. I think it's just a motion, right?
except for the Title I, because we did not encumber any funds for that. Other than that, I don't know if you have anything to report.
Do anyone else have any thoughts on this? No?
I do have, next year's budget is now up on the website with the revised format as it's shown now in the packet, with the accounts in summary form, so that way we're not identifying any staff members' health insurance.
Great.
So it is now up on the website like that for next year as well.
Thank you. New business. Lori, will you please do the honors of explaining this general assurances?
So you received this document. We actually received communication from the School Boards Association saying, you know, they do certainly recommend that boards just approve this.
Yeah.
This is a communication from the Commissioner of Education, their general, what we call general assurances, and you know, certainly we can chime in, but these are basically kind of the rules of the road, if you will, for spending, they're kind of accounting practices, spending practices, procedures, some of it gets into policy, a lot of the things you hear, you say, oh, that sounds familiar. We have policy around this. So it's kind of, you know, the guidelines on how to spend what you can and can't do. It talks about, you know, supplanting versus like supplementing budget, you know, all of those kinds of things. We've not ever seen a document like this before. They are assurances that are come like this in this format. Typically, they're a part of each grant application. So, you know, Title I, Title II, Title III, if you have Title III, maybe you have some of those students. Some of the other grants, just for example, we have federal dollars that like support the career tech centers, you know, with the 21st Century that supports, you know, like after school programs and things like that. There are a number of different federal grant programs, and that's what this is for. So it's, like I said, I don't know all of the reason behind this, but this is something that has been pushed out by the commissioner's office and has, you know, again, the School Boards Association has recommended signing it. It's not really something we certainly can debate and discuss, but the document can't be changed. So it kind of is what it is, if you will. And so it's a document that we have to return by the end of this month. So I would need a signature from the board, as well as my own, to send it back to Concord and make sure we have everything in. Because if you don't do these things, then you don't get your federal funds.
Yeah, it just sounds to me like they took all the separate documents that we've always had to send for our grants and kind of put it into one document to sign versus having separate documents.
They did.
Right? Yeah.
However, the next day, so we talked with this at the Summersville School Board meeting on Tuesday night. On Wednesday, I received Title I, Title II, and Title III
yeah.
assurances. So I'm like, okay, so, all right, well, we'll just sign them and send them all back.
And
so,
everything in that document are things that we're already doing.
Right.
You know, we're doing our monthly reporting for grants. We're making sure we're supplementing our programs instead of supplanting. So you can't use funds that the budget should be covering. I mean, we're already doing all these things. It's just merely giving the board's approval
right.
that we're already doing these things.
Right. So making sure that you're aware, because this also comes up during the auditing mm-hmm. process.
Yeah.
So when the auditors come in, they not only look at dollars and cents, if you will, but they also look at our compliance around these things. So like last year, I had to go in and talk about, you know, some of the different things and how do we make sure that we're being accountable for this, that, and the other thing. So so that it is a part of that process as well. So I don't have any questions about it or at all. But
I don't think you answered.
It seems like pretty routine.
It is routine.
Like.
It really is. So I think it's just so you know, and then I'll just grab your signature afterwards.
Okay.
So glad I got a chance to read that. It's just grateful.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm sure it was meaningful reading for you. Some you read before you're trying to fall asleep.
Exactly.
Contract items?
I think that's kind of outstanding item that you have had, if there are some concerns that you've had. I know there's a list of things that, you know, as you get ready to go forward and look at that contract, you know, I think it's just one of the, again, outstanding items. It's like, oh, hey, we need to make sure that we, you know, make sure that this gets put on the list. So I don't know if there are any issues or concerns, but.
Any updates about the Lead Start?
They were actually having another meeting today at 3:00. So I don't know yet, but I will certainly keep us updated.
Great.
Next one.
Future meeting dates, do not have a meeting next month, but we do in August, the first meeting of the next school year, before we know. School events, the only one I know about is the Summer Swords graduation tomorrow at UNH. I will be there. And you will be there too, right, Laura?
Be on the stage.
Any other events?
We have sixth grade breakfast at Fogarty's. We have all school awards at 9:00. We have the Summerton High School graduates coming to do their clap off here at 11:30. We have step up day in the afternoon where our kids do step up for the next group. And then we have our sixth grade clap off tomorrow afternoon at 3:15.
And meeting buddies.
It's going to be awesome. We flag day today. It was beautiful. And
oh,
it was
beautiful.
Our kids all went up and shook their hands and said thank you for your service. It was beautiful. It was really nice.
It was
the best event of my time here.
Yeah, I think it's probably the best event since I've been here.
Oh,
it was just.
I skipped over the most important part.
I'm going to add a special second section for the most important part. Tom couldn't be here with us tonight. He's traveling for work. But he did prepare some remarks for you, Kate. And he's very sorry that he couldn't be here. But Andrea has agreed to share those with everyone.
I'm trying to get through it without getting emotional. You will see Tom's flair shining. All right, let us tell you about our principal. If you look around this building, even just in this gym, you will see some of the many wonderful things.
I know.
Don't do it.
That have been accomplished since she came on board several weeks ago. All right. This is only a small representation of things that have changed here under our principal. But we want to tell you about these things you can't necessarily see with your eyes. The things that have made our principal so remarkable. Our principal has been our board partner. She has worked hand in hand with us to make this cool template of educational excellence. A partner who let us know all the great things happening here at RGS, but was not afraid to tell us what we didn't want to hear. Our principal has been a leader, moving initiatives forward, pushing the envelope, challenging staff and our kids with equal energy and determination, all to make this a premier center of education. Our principal has been the heart of our school. She has celebrated the great accomplishments of our staff and students, but has shepherded them as well through challenging, even sad times, letting them know that we will be okay.
Okay.
Our principal's focus is our children. She realizes every child here is a small piece to the RGS puzzle, and the puzzle is not complete without each and every one of them. She wants them to succeed. She wants to teach them to be hungry for more of what life has to offer, to be good students, to be good people. That's our principal.
That's Kate Lucas.
On a personal note, I have to share. I asked Jack, my fifth grader, you know, what he'll remember. And now he even said today that he still remembers feeling so comfortable with you
at kindergarten, to just walk in your office and share things with you. And that really just shows it all. The RGS board would like to thank you for your partnership and leadership. We couldn't have done it without you. On behalf of the town, thank you for making the school more of a shining gem. For the hundreds of kids you have seen come through these doors, thank you for caring and loving every one of them every day. And from the parents of all your students, thank you, Kate Lucas, for helping our kids to believe in themselves and caring for them and keeping them safe.
Thank you.
Sorry, I tried. Sorry. I didn't do too badly though.
Okay.
But Tom did a great job.
Can I share something really quickly because it's about Tom's daughter? So everybody in Betty Nichols' class wrote me a card and I came in today and they wanted to each read them to me. And Morgan's was last. So she's the cutest thing ever. She says to me, "You were my first principal and my favorite principal. You would always make my day better and you're funny. You're just funny. You're the best. Even though you're not my sister, it feels like you are." And then she gave the biggest hug inside of my lap and said, "Let's go to Starbucks." She's in second grade.
Now we have closing comments. I think we covered that. Any comments from visitors this evening?
Just one. Besides the roof being done, is there any other planned work going on this summer?
I believe there's a whole list.
Okay. There's all sorts of stuff.
You and I should talk.
Okay, sounds good. Is it about rec? I meet with Brittany and we're all set. I mean, Brittany's here every day. Okay, we'll talk about it.
Perfect.
Roll call.
Here, Andrea, listen.